Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. Today we will talk about the potency and efficacy of drugs and with their definitions with suitable examples and also the factors which affect the potency and efficacy of drugs. So, starting with potency, well, the word potency is derived from our word fortis, which means powerful or able. It is a property of drugs, which can be defined as that it is the concentration or dose of a drug required to produce a 50% response of the drug emacs, mean maximal effect, which is equal to 100% response of the drug. Or potency is the ability of a drug to show action of a given magnitude. For example, we have three drugs named A, B, and C of same class, and they are given to patients and their dose or response curve are obtained as shown in the diagram, in which the response is taken on y-axis and dose of drug is taken on x-axis. By comparing the doses of drugs required to show half of the drug maximal responses, it is clear that all of the drug shows potencies but which are not the same, because each drug requires a different dose to show 50% of the maximal effect, as shown in the diagram. That drug A requires a small dose to show 50% of the maximal effect than the drug B and C. Thus, drug A is said to be more potent than the drug B and C, and B is more potent than C and lesser potent than drug A, and drug C shows the least potency as compared to the other drug. The next topic of our lecture is efficacy. Well, the word efficacy is derived from a Latin word efficacia, which means effective. It is another property of drugs, which is defined as it is the concentration or dose of a drug required to show maximal response or effect. In the above definition, EC means effective concentration and ED means effective dose. And EC50 or ED50 means it is the amount of drug required to show response in 50% of population. Efficacy can be also defined as it is the ability of a drug to show maximal response. And for more understanding of efficacy, let's move to the above example. In this example, all of the three drugs A, B, and C shows efficacy but which are not the same. Because drug C has the highest level of response, so it is said to be more efficacious than drug B and A. And similarly, drug B is more efficacious than drug A. But one point to be noted here, it is not necessary for a drug to be most efficacious and less potent, or most potent and less efficacious. And moreover, the drug selection for treatment purposes mainly done on the basis of efficacy. And after that, the efficacy and potency of a drug is a comparative study between two or more drugs of the same class or of the same actions. One of the causes of variation of potencies and efficacies between or among drugs is that the one drug may be full agonist and the other drug of the class may be partial agonist. So it would be not able to activate the receptor as the full agonist do it. And, moreover, it also depends upon the drug receptor complex location. For example, loop diuretics are more powerful than the other diuretics. And it also depends upon the drug dosage form in which the drug is given. For example, the IV drugs are more potent than a drug used through oral route. And thus, the potency and efficacy of the same drug can be varied when the route of administration is changed.
Thanks for watching our video, and support us by subscribing our channel.